Hello students, welcome back to the new session. So let's start with a quick revision. In the last class, we learned about how to edit your text and combine text. So in editing, I told you, you can do it through your properties palette or you can edit by invoking the editing tool, that is de-edit or t-edit. You can even edit the scale or justification of your text by typing scale text or justify text. And combining text is nothing but you can change your single line text into a multi line text. So you have these settings as well to sort it as top to down or select auto to text as in the selection order. Okay. So this was a very simple one, and I had also shown you the multi line text through an example by using different editing tools like keeping a text bold, how to stack a particular number, if you want to write 1/2 inches, how to insert a symbol, how to make it italic, how to rotate it. So all of these things I had taught you in the past session. In today's session, I'll tell you how to insert tables in your drawing. See, tables is also one of the important factor for your overall presentation. Like for example, if I talk about architecture field, so we have these legends to make regarding our drawings, wherein we specify each and everything about our drawing, like the symbolization of different hatches or colors, or even about the different dimensions of our doors or windows. Same in if I talk about mechanical domain, so we have different factors like you want to specify the names of the parts, or you want to give numbers to your parts of your object or your mechanical part. So here you require tables, like you draw a tables in your Excel. So same way you can draw, insert tables in your drawings. So you can invoke this tool by going into your ribbon, in home tab, in annotation you will find tables, or in your annotate tab, in tables you will find table. So there are two options in ribbon. In tool palette you can go to draw and then table. Menu bar again, draw, table, toolbar, draw, table, or in your command line, you can type table and press enter. So here in your table panel, the first icon which is there written as table is your invoke tool for starting inserting your tables. So when you click on this table, this icon, this is what is there in front of you, the insert table dialog box, which has different areas. The first area is table style, second is insert options, third is insertion behavior, then is column and row settings, and the last one is set cell styles. I'll be discussing each and every one with you. Okay. So when I talk about table style, it is nothing but the different styles as the names are given here. Even you can make table styles in your AutoCAD, which I'll be discussing after this topic. Yes, it is a part of the session itself. So by default, AutoCAD has one table style, that is standard. You can see one icon here. If you click on this, this is the table style dialog box. So you can launch this table style dialog box here itself and create a new table style as well. Okay. Otherwise, from this drop-down menu, you can select the table styles. By default, there is only one standard. Okay. Then you have insert options. Herein you have three options: start from empty table, from a data link, or from object data in the drawing. So basically first is start from empty table, wherein you do not have any data and you are going to type each and everything. Okay. Second is from a data link. So herein this option basically enables you to create a table automatically in AutoCAD from an Excel sheet. Okay. So herein basically when you click on this button here, it will launch the Data Link Manager dialog box. Okay, so I'll show you this in CAD and then I'll move on. So I'll type table. See, this is my insert table dialog box. Or I can go to home tab, in annotation I can find this table. See, or in annotate, in tables I can click on table. then also I'll get this insert. So first one is table style. See, by default it is just one standard. I can go in this and launch the table style dialog box. I'll come to this after this. First I'll tell you how to insert tables, then I'll come to the new table style. The second option is insert options. You have three radio buttons. The first button is start from empty table. So herein you can create a table that is empty and you can manually put the data. Second is from a data link. So as of now it has no data links found. So I can launch the data link manager. When I click on data link manager or this icon, this is a select a data link dialog box in front of me, wherein I have this Excel links. As of now I have no links, so I can create a new Excel data link. When I click on this, it will ask me enter a data link name. So I can say sheet 1, for example. Okay, I'll say okay, and it will open a new Excel data link sheet which has a name sheet 1. So it is asking me use an existing file or browse for a new one. So I can create a new one or I can use an existing Excel file. Okay, so I can, by clicking on this, I can browse in my save as folder. Okay, and I can give the path type, like for example I want to give a full path, I want to give a relative path or no path. Okay, so by default it has full path. When I click on this, I have to select an Excel file. So for example, I have a file here. You can select any Excel file and open, and when I select on open, it will show me another dialog box, new Excel data link. So I have now this link here. Okay, I've already chosen my Excel file. You can change also. Now the path type is full path. Okay, link options here gives me select Excel sheet to link to sheet 1, sheet 2 or sheet 3. So I have three sheets, for example, in my Excel sheet. So you can say which sheet you want to link. For example, I want to link sheet 1. Now you have option, you want to link entire sheet? Yes, linked entire sheet. That means the entire worksheet in the form of table will be there in your drawing. Okay, or you can select the link to a name range. If you have a defined name ranges from the Excel sheet. Or you can select link to range. So like for example, here A1 is to M9. So basically you have to give the range of the cell. Okay, see, and enter a range in one of the following formats. A1 is to D10 for a rectangular region. A is to A for a single column. A is to D for a set of columns. So whatever you want to link the range to, so you can just type here. Okay, or you can link the entire sheet. See, the entire sheet is too large to display. So as of now, it is not showing me. Otherwise, I can uncheck the preview as well. Okay, so if I click on OK, now it has added sheet 1. Okay, and it is showing me the link name, file name and filling details as well. You have one few more things. You have this more option. When I click on this, you have this cell content area and cell formatting area as well. Here you have three things: keep data formats and formulas. So basically it will import all the data's formats, all the data which are there in your Excel into your drawing. Second option is keep data formats, solve formulas in Excel. So it will import the data formats, but the formulas will be there in your Excel sheet. By default, the radio button is convert data formats to text and solve formulas in Excel. So it will convert data formats to a text here in AutoCAD, and still you have to solve your formulas in Excel. Okay, so these are the three radio buttons you can choose from. And there is a checkbox, allow writing to source file. Okay, so basically this checkbox is selected by default. It enables you to choose the download from source. I will show you where it is, button in your tables panel. It is there, download from source. Okay, so basically it updates the changes made in the drawing table. So if it is not checked here, so the table will be imported, but after importing, the changes which is there in your Excel sheet won't be updated in your drawing. Okay, so it is important for you to check this checkbox. In cell formatting, there is a checkbox use Excel formatting. So basically, it is to import all the formatting settings in relation to this particular file. So you have two radio buttons: keep table updated to Excel formatting, start with Excel formatting, do not update. So by default, AutoCAD has this radio button on, which is start with Excel formatting, do not update. Basically, here any formatting changes specified in the Excel sheet will be imported to the table, but the changes made in the Excel sheet would not be updated here. Okay, and if the second button is keep the table updated to Excel formatting. So whenever you format or you change your Excel sheet, the updation will be done in your table as well in AutoCAD. Okay, but this updation will only show when you download the source. Okay, so there are two options: download from source and upload to source. So whenever you do changes here in your AutoCAD, it will upload to source as well. That is, it will change the update the in the Excel sheet as well. Okay, and if you download from source, the updation done in the Excel sheet will be shown in your table as well, because these are linked. Okay, so you can click on OK and come out. Alright, the third option is from object data in the drawing. So basically, it creates a table automatically. Okay, herein data extraction is done. So AutoCAD extracts the data within your drawing. Okay, it will from the objects created within your drawing. So when you click on this radio button, and you have, because I have a, as of now I have no data here. So otherwise, if you have this radio button on, and if I click on OK, okay, the AutoCAD will start the data extraction wizard, which will guide you how to insert the required data in a form of a table. Okay, so as of now I have nothing, so I cannot use, so I'll use start from empty table. So and you can see this preview. I hope you all are clear. So these two are clear. Now these two are clear, and you clear in the insert option area. You have three things: from a data link, from start from an empty table, and from object data in the drawing. So data extraction in Excel, link, data link. You can create a new Excel data link from your computer or your laptop, and insert and link an Excel sheet with your table. Okay, wherever you require, you can modify these tools. Okay, now coming to the next one. Next portion is insertion behavior area, which has two things: specify insertion point and specify window. In columns and row settings area, you have four things: column, data rows, column width, and row height. In set cell styles area, you have first row cell, all other rows cell styles, in second rows cell style. So insertion behavior, first is specify insertion point. So this is basically, there are two ways to insert your table in your drawing. First is specify insertion point. So whenever you select this, you will get a particular insertion point here when you come out of this complete dialog box after all the settings. Specify window will specify a size and location of the table. So it will ask you to specify two points. So within that two points, within that window basically, it will create a table. Okay. So as per the selection, these columns and row settings are visible to you. Like if I say specify insertion point, I have all the settings here switched on. Okay. So according to insert options and insertion behavior, this column and row settings are switched on or switched off. And if I go and specify window, I cannot type data rows and column width. I can just type columns and I can give row heights. Okay, because rows can be decided automatically and column width also automatically, because you will create a window here, and according to the size of the window, it will show. Okay, columns you can decide, but rows will be automatically. So as and when you go on typing, the rows will be created. Okay, and column width would be according to your size of your window. Row height you can specify, height of the row in every line. Okay, so if I say specify insertion point, I can set my columns as here it is 5. I can specify column width, I can specify data rows, I can specify the row height. Then I have set cell style. So basically, this is the cell styles. The first row cell style is always title. If you go to the data drop-down menu, you have three things, data, header and title. So by default, the first row is of title, second row is of header and all the other rows is of data. Okay, you can change the order if you want. Okay, click on OK. See, it has an insertion point. I can click here. So now, as in Excel, it has columns defined in alphabetical order and rows in numerical order. Okay, so here in the first row is of title. The second row will be of headers. And from the third row in the column, it will start the data cells. Okay. Now you also have this text editor switched on. So you can edit and type the data according to your requirement. You can change the height, you can change the font, you can make it bold, you can change the color, you can do the justification, everything. Okay. These are the headers and this is the data. Okay, so when you click, see the table cell editor is also open. I'll teach you that in the next session. So as of now, just understand how to insert the table in a drawing. So I hope you all are clear. You all are clear about this, all these points. Great. Now I'll show you how to create a new table style. For that, you can invoke this through going into ribbon, your home tab. In annotation, you have this table style option, or in your menu bar in format table style, in toolbar go to styles or table style, or in command line you can type table style. Even when you go into inserting a new table, there is an option I had shown you. You can launch the new tab style from there itself also. Okay, so this is the table style dialog box. So the current table style as is by default is standard. So the styles will be listed here. Okay, the preview, and there are four options: set current, new, modify and delete. So you can delete your table style, you can modify your table style, existing table style, you can create a new table style, and even you can set the table style selected by you or created by you as current. Okay, so when you click on new, this is the create new table style dialog box which appears in front of you. Therein you have two things: new style name and start with standard, and you can click on continue. Okay, so by default start with is always standard. So start with basically on which you want to base your style with. So if you take standard as the base style, so on that you can create a new style. You can go to annotation here, table style. This is your table style dialog box. Okay, or otherwise in annotate, in tables, see here is the, this is your standard table style. So you can go to manage table style. Okay, herein this is your table style dialog box. In this, see the styles here by default is standard. This is a preview of the standard style. The first is title, then header, then all the data cells. There is a list option, styles in use and all styles. So styles, as of now we have one style, so both the options will be same. Otherwise you can say the styles which the drawing is using, this is the list, or otherwise all the styles there in your AutoCAD. So you have four options. So I'll go into new. Now it is writing saying new style name, so copy of standard. So I can, or otherwise I'll say okay, new style one. Okay, and I can start with the standard because I have only one, so I'll say continue. When I say continue, this is the dialog box which appears in front of me. Okay, so I have options here. starting table, general, the cell styles have few options. Okay. So starting table is nothing but select the table to start from, the base basically. So herein you have option to select a table in your drawing, which already you have as a reference for formatting the current table style. Okay. So when you select that particular table, the table style which is associated with that particular table is copied, and then on that new style will be created. Okay. So basically you are modifying the current style. So you have two buttons here. One is to copy and one is remove. So if you select the remove one, that will remove the starting table from the table style. If it has, if it is, if you do not have a particular table style, so it won't delete. Otherwise, it will remove the starting table from this table style. General area is basically about table direction. So herein by default you have down direction. So as in first is title, second is line is header, and then is data. Otherwise you have another option, that is up. So in that I'll show you in preview, it will, the data will be upper side and title and header will be downside. Okay, the order will change. So by default it is down. In cell styles again, so you can specify like three cell styles are there, title, header and data. So according to these titles, header and data, you can change these properties of the cells, that is general properties, text properties and border. Okay, along with it you can even create new cell styles and manage the cell styles. So I'll show you all these in AutoCAD. So see, first option is select a table. I have this table. Okay, so I have selected. So this is my preview. It is showing me this table. So I can do the changes within this table itself. I can change the properties of this particular table. I can change the direction. Like as of now, it is down. So I can change the direction to up. Okay. Okay. So see. Now that up, when I selected the table direction as up, the title has gone down, the header has gone down, the data is up. So by default, it is down, and you can even select up. Okay. Now the cell styles. Okay. When I select this table, now I have this remove button on. I can remove this table also. Okay. Otherwise, what will happen? This table which I selected, it will first copy the table style from, that is the standard style, and then modify and apply on this table also. If you do not want to apply and you just want to create a table style and keep it for further tables, you do not have to select the table from your drawing. Just create a new one and keep it. Okay. Herein we have three cell style, data, header and title. So you can just click on one and change the properties, and then select the second one and change the properties. You can do two things, create new cell style and manage cell styles. I'll come to this first. I'll show you these three tabs. First is the general tab. In this you have all the properties like fill color. So you can give a color to a particular cell, the data cells. Like for example, if I select title, I can give yellow color to title. So see, you can check the preview, see the preview. Alignment is middle center, I can say middle right, or I can change it to top left. So accordingly, it will change the alignment. Format is general. I can select any of the format like angle, currency, data, date, decimal, okay, percentage, text. So I have general, okay, by default. I can change the format of the same as you work in Excel. Then type, label or data. Margins you can specify, horizontal and vertical margins. Okay. Then you also have a checkbox here for merge cells on row and column creation. So basically this checkbox is selected to merge all the new rows and columns created by using this cell style into one cell, because this is a title cell. When I go into data cell, it will be unchecked. When in title, we have already saying that it should merge these cells. Okay. Now text, about text, you can change the text style. As of now, it has two, standard and annotative. You can change the text height. You can change the text color. Okay. You can even give an angle to your text. Okay. The next is borders. Don't press enter, it will come out of the dialog box. Next is borders. In borders, herein you have different properties like line weight, line type, and color again. Okay. You can give double line to your border. You can specify the spacing of your double line if you have. These are different borders. Complete border, all borders, outside border, inside border, only the bottom border, side borders, left, right, up, or no borders. So you have all this, like I say, apply selected properties to all the borders. Okay. Okay. Now two more things which you have is create a new cell style or manage cell styles. So when I click on create a new style, I can create, give a name to the style. I can start with title. I click on continue. I can create a new style here with new properties. Okay. So this will be a copy of the title. Like I have three cell styles, data, header, and title. You can create another cell style. Okay. Or you can manage. When you go into manage, you can delete this particular cell style. You can rename the cell style, or again you can create new cell style. Okay. So I say delete. I do not want to keep this copy of the title. Okay. Other than that, you can just select your new style, set as current, or you can again go to modify and modify the settings. Okay. So, not difficult, a very simple one. So, that's all. Specify the starting table, the base style, specify the general table directions, specify the cell style which you want to select and edit. There are few properties, you can edit the borders, you can edit the text, you can general properties like you can give a color, you can set the alignment, margins, the format, each and everything. Okay, you can manage your cell styles, you can create a new cell style. Okay, so all are clear, general tab, text tab, border tab, manage cell size. Okay, you can even set a table style as current and you can modify the table style. So I've covered each and every thing. So I hope you all are clear how to insert a table and how to create a new table style. Before ending the session, I would like to give you an assignment. This is your next assignment. So herein, again, try to complete this assignment. This is not about text. It is just for your practice. You do not have to dimension it. You just have to make this object. You have circle, you have arcs, each and every measurement is given. Okay. So try to do this and submit in a drawing format. Okay. So that's all. Next class, we'll do a quick revision and we'll move on to how to modify tables. I'll show you how to modify these tables, which I had shown you today. When you select a particular table, the text or table cell will appear in your ribbon. So we'll be discussing about that in the next session. Thank you, students.